Lesson 1.2, and our goal is to use order of operations to evaluate expressions. So go ahead and set your notes up. So that goal is at the top and you have a section for questions. Today we're going to write in a conclusion. Start off your notes by writing at the top, describe the difference between an algebraic expression and an equation. And today we want to think about what is an algebraic expression and how is it the same, similar, or different than an equation. Also, you'll notice that I tried to shine a little bit more light on our notes today, and it worked in some places, in other places it didn't. So here are some examples of algebraic expressions. Six, three n, and five squared plus three x. These are examples of algebraic expressions. Here's some examples of equations. 6 equals 5n plus 1, 3x equals 5 squared plus y. The difference between the algebraic expressions and the equations is the equal sign. Notice that there's an equal sign right here, there's an equal sign right here, but up here there are no equal signs. For our first example, we're going to evaluate an expression given a value. So the expression is 2x minus 8 when the value of x is 4. So we replace the x value, we replace the x with its value of 4. So where I highlighted in yellow the x, I'm going to replace with a 4. 2 times 4 is 8, 8 minus 8 is 0, so this is an example of evaluating an expression. So our conclusion is an expression contains numbers, operations, and variables. So this is an evaluated expression. So our conclusion again is an expression contains numbers, operations, and variables. Example number 2 is going to be a table. The table is going to be 3 columns wide and 5 rows down. So if you want to count down 5 lines or make 5 lines in 3 columns, the first column is going to be x. The second column is going to be the expression, negative 3x plus 7. And the last column is the output. X values of negative 2, 0, 4, and 9 are going to be used. And we're going to replace the values of x where you see the x in the expression. So first we'll do negative 3 times negative 2 plus 7. And notice each time we just replace the x with its value. So we replaced x with negative 2, 0, 4, and 9. So now we have to compute these values. negative 3 times 2 plus 7, and we're going to put that right here. That's 13. So I'm just repeating 4 times, finding each time I'm finding the value. For example 3, in that last part, I was just showing where the output numbers came from. Okay, for this last example, we're going to be given an equation and values for the variables and asked to determine do these values create a solution. So the equation is 3x plus 2y equals 8. The values are x equals 2 and y equals 1. So we're going to replace this x with that value, this y with that value, and see if that remains true, see if that does equal 8. I've highlighted the X in yellow and the Y in pink. So 3 times 2 plus 2 times 1 is 6 plus 2, that's equal to 8. Since 8 does equal 8, that's a true statement, then it's true X equals 2 and Y equals 1 provide a solution for the equation. So yes, these values are a solution for this equation.